So I have this piece of fabric, which is 150 centimeters width and about 120 lengths on grain line. So, and in some part of this piece I created a smoking, just two lines of smoking on the one side, and this is the right side of fabric, and this is how smoking looks on the right side. So I fixed, I positioned the smoking part on the shoulder, and I'm going to do one shoulder dress. So here I just inserted three pins following the, let's say, the drapes of the folds of the smoking, right? And into the shoulder now, right? And now I'm going to use the folds that already created coming from the smoking part, and I will use them to create actually the pleats on the dress on the right and left side. Yes, I also inserted one pin here just to keep the piece on the waistline right here. So we have fixed shoulder part and one pin in the waist. So now I'm going to do just fold it 2 centimeters for the facing, and I'm going to create the neckline. Right now, all this amount of fabric, all this excess, we are going to pleat using the direction of the smoking part. So I'm just creating pleats here, and I just fix these pleats on the sides here. So one by one. So you see, I don't make them tight because the pleats here will look nicer. Just easy pleats. You may improvise with the pleats. It's not necessary to make them equal in terms of size. You can improvise. Make them just randomly. So now we have you can actually make them like the first draft, and then you can improve the pleats later. So just maybe. Yeah, and then. So basically, you will have a side seam here, and here I will create the rest of this fabric. I will go into the lid. So one side is more or less clear, right? So let's see what we can do with another one, right? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the same side of the fabric, and I use this side to create actually an armhole. Yes. Approximately the same level as this side here, so about bust level. And here you look at your sides. So now we're going to use all this amount that we have here and create holes again. Like pleats. So you can start from anywhere you want. Maybe you can start from the side. So, and you just evaluate the amount of fabric you have and create bigger or smaller pleats. Right, this is maybe the first draft. Yes, maybe you can change something here, right? Because the small pleats will not look good, so maybe you can make where you have the small one, you can combine two pleats and make one. And just try something else. So, and this is, I give you so we still have a room for experimentation and for exploring. But basically we created, almost created the dress here and the front part. But if you want to make longer dress, you have to stitch another piece of fabric on the green line here, right? And then trim on both sides here and here, and then trim the hemline the way you want, or you can trim now, right? Now we have the length here, maybe shorter here, maybe a little bit longer on the other side. So you can decide and trim the hemline with already existing piece of fabric, right? What you have here on the side, so this is going to be cut away, right? So you have to finalize your drapes, right? Maybe nicer, looking nicer. So basically you have your sides here, you can trim it, right? You can cut it, and right, following your side seam position, yes. So from the hip line, right, you see side seam and hip line coming together, this is a point, and from here you just draw a vertical line down, so perpendicular to the floor. So this will be your side seam, right, and the side seam goes through this and this point on the waistline, and all this piece will be cut away, right? So this will be the front part of the dress, right? So as I said, you still have some room to experiment, to change something in terms of pleating, right? And so later you will create, you will just drape the back part. And this is the dress which can be made basically in 1-2 days.